negative about Rita Tinina. I have been doing the same. I have gone through all the tributes, the things that have been said by friends and colleagues of Rita. For Rita's friends and family, let me confirm what they have said about Rita is true. If you are not Rita's friend, then you are not a good person. There is a problem with you. That is simply Rita. If Rita is not your friend, you have a problem. There is a problem with you. It is difficult not to be Rita's friend. I worked with Rita in KTN. She's an amazing person. She's the most humble reporter I've worked with. For the young news producers, Ken, Zubeida, Janet, and even the senior news producers, you will agree with me that the most difficult bulletin to produce is the 1 o'clock bulletin. It looks very useless. It's the most difficult bulletin to produce. It has some pressure. You don't know where it comes from. You have 20 minutes to 1 o'clock and you have only one story. You don't know what to put on air at 1 o'clock. Rita was that reporter that you would tell her, get me 3 stories for 1 o'clock. She would get you packaged stories for 1 o'clock. Unajua, these senior reporters wako na kiburi mingi sana. You tell them to do a story for 1 o'clock, wanasema hawana, after intern. I'm too busy, I'm working on 9 p.m. Rita would never say that. Rita would never say a story is small. During one of the last interviews that the media had with the president, and the president was asking, na huyo msichana, huyo Masai alienda wapi? Because we were just talking about journalists generally, and he said, huyo msichana alienda wapi? He was a very good reporter. Tukamwambia, she's going to produce news as a news producer, sasa ako NTV. It is true, I have come to confirm that Rita was a very good journalist. Okay. I want to say just 2 things about Rita Tinina. Rita Tinina was a true professional journalist. Wakati tulikuwa tumeshikwa na wazimu wa siasa in 2005, 2006, 2007, and my mentors Joe Ageo and Linus would confirm, when we had lost our senses as politicians and even as journalists, and we were all competing on who's going to ban this country. I had been attached to cover the ODM wing of the politicians that time. So when Kibaki won the election, or when, according to ODM, Kibaki stole the election, I took a lot of time to call Mwai Kibaki president. I had been consumed by the madness of the moment. So I called him PNU's Mwai Kibaki. Linus Kaikai called me and told me, Emmanuel, you are a journalist. Mwai Kibaki is president. The measure of good journalism is not in color, it is not in grammar, it is in your ability to hide or to conceal your personal opinions in a story that you are doing. That is what Rita Tinina was able to do without instructions, without guidance. While most of us journalists, we've been branded either because of the names, because of our associations, you will all agree with me, including the politicians here, that it was very difficult to say Rita Tinina belongs to this political camp or the other political camp. She was simply a journalist. Rita Tinina was simply a journalist. I wish Eric Latif was here. I don't know who, because I have to make some confession before we bury Rita. And my good friend Robert Yeah, my brother, take no offense. When Rita came to KIMC, because we joined KIMC the same time, same day, same class, I thought she was going to be my wife. She was so beautiful. She was brown. And she was Maasai. So I thought I had found a wife. But one day, aliona nimekuja sana, akaniambia, young man, wacha haraka, you will get another wife. Tusome kwanza. So I remember we had a very special program on Metro Radio called Love Zone. It was done by Eric Latif. So I've come to confess that I am the anonymous guy who sent Rita a special song. A song that I've just found today makes a lot of sense and very symbolic. From a distance. From a distance, Rita has gone to rest. She has gone to be with the Lord. We thank God for her. Kindly allow me. Okay, nimeambiwa kulingana na itifaki, because we have some leaders who've come also to eulogize with us, we reserve the president's speech. It's a very simple thing, which... Why can't I just finish? It's no problem. Nobody will take offense.